Contribution is from Indonesia, and a speaker earlier this morning mentioned that Indonesia is another country which CSR activity is mandatory. So if I could ask our presenter from the PT Bank Mandiri, Persera, which is a Mandiri micro-business, to come up. And again, if you could keep your presentation for about 10 minutes, then that would give us some time for audience interaction.
Very good afternoon, everyone. First of all, my name is Harry Gunardi, Micro and Retail Banking Director of Bank Mandiri. I'm standing here on behalf of Bank Mandiri and also our partners is Gajah Mada University. It is such an honor to be awarded by Golden Peacock Global Award 2014, especially for the corporate social responsibility. We are humble that you would place your faith and trust in us. This is a responsibility that we do not take lightly. So in this moment also, I'd like to thank Professor Ali Agus and also Dr. Didi Agyani, both of our come from University of Gajah Mada, going with me together. So, I also like to thank the Golden Peacock Global Award Committee, judges, fellow award participants, conference participants, the government of India, and all the team members who work tirelessly to help us achieve this accomplishment. First of all, now I would like to share a little bit of our journey and experience about the Mandiri Bersama Mandiri program. Mandiri basically is the name of the Bank Mandiri. Mandiri bahasa meaning independent, standalone. Mandiri Bersama Mandiri is meaning independent with Bank Mandiri. So I would like also to give a little bit of background. Bank Mandiri is one of the largest bank in the country, Indonesia. So we have more than 3,000 branches across the country. We also have ATM machine, almost 13,000. EDC machine, more than 270,000 EDC machine. With total employees around 70,000 employees. So let's go to the next slide. Actually, in Indonesia, urbanization is a growing social phenomena. So the widespread view that in the big cities provide more opportunities. People from the villages would like to move from the small village and from big city, for instance, like Jakarta is capital city, meaning the big city can give everything, many opportunity for them. And then that's one of the big phenomena in Indonesia. So where in fact, Indonesia has natural resources are sufficient to support the people in the country. It is only the limited resources and capability to manage locally available potential to support the livelihood in rural area that make living in rural areas seem difficult. So moreover, life in the big city is getting more challenging with overpopulation and dwindling resources issues. So these are the base of Bank Mandiri program. We call Mandiri Bersama Mandiri, Be Independent with Mandiri program, a part of its CSR, corporate social responsibility for the banks. The program seeks to help rural area develop their potential by providing them with the necessary resources and sustainability method. Having analyzed the facts and issues at hand, we must forward to implement the program in the right way. So the next slide, there is the main frame of the program. The fundamental objective of the Mandiri Bersama Mandiri is to develop self-reliant community through a total solution approach, which is a comprehensive and integrated mentoring in a local potential environment, which arm for Mandiri Pangan. This is in Bahasa, in English is food self-sufficiency, mandiri energy, meaning energy self-sufficiency, and also the last one is masyarakat mandiri, is independent community. And to create a social entrepreneurship that influence the community development and environment within a region. So the total solution approach includes a social cultural development, which is transforming and reinforcing the social culture of the community development toward a more forward-thinking society. And also infrastructure development, where we facilitate and develop public and production infrastructure along with the local community to support the improvement of the quality and the standard of life of the community. And the other one also followed by the strengthening of economic institution in which we support locally run productive unit in terms of production, human resources management, financial management, and also the business legal. And the last one is the program also provide transfer technology, where the program facilitator assists in mentoring the community to apply efficient technology to enhance the local potential. And last but not least, also we providing also the market access, where a more expansive knowledge of the market, enhancing the network through the greater access to market, will assist them, will assist the community greatly in developing their business. So the pilot project actually was implemented in the, we call it the Argorejo village, a very small village located in central Java, one of the island of Indonesia. So Argorejo was selected to host the pilot project due to its underdeveloped state, despite it is enormous potential. So the project makes use of many food crop found locally and also improve them in terms of the both productivity and the product variety. So the program implementation actually is conducted through cooperation between Bank Mandiri and University of Gajah Mada, as I mentioned in the beginning presentation. So as the project funding agent, we call a micro mandiri, engages a practitioner from Universitas Gajah Mada to facilitate the knowledge and technology transfer while providing an advisory function to rural communities. The program is implemented in four program activities, which are: first one is rice productivity improvement, the second one is oyster mushroom cultivation, and the third one is optimization of lawn or garden, and the fourth one is farming and freshwater fishery program, which provide training in catfish and livestock farming. So the next slide will tell us each project stand is truly facilitated by both institution Bank Mandiri Universitas Gajah Mada, and then to measure progress, four indicators are measured: productivity, basically increase, land use, asset growth, and also the income growth. Two notable achievements are on the third, one-third increase in term of income through rice productivity improvement and creation of new income stream from previously non-existent businesses in the beneficiary villages, such as mushroom cultivation and also freshwater fishery, which is good for the villages that where we already implemented the project. So we also have, the next slide will tell us, we also have a son here. Within 6 months in the project initiation, the rice intensification program in Argorejo brought a 20% increase in rice yield from 7.4 tons to 9.3 tons per hectare, translating a rise in farmer income by more or less 31%. Overall, result varied from pilot to pilot due to the different condition of the soil and also the discipline of the field workers. In addition, people from the village are aware about the new technology that are beneficial from their livelihood. make use the technology proven to be effective for application within the local context by utilizing the village surrounding environment, such as organic farming technique, using organic fertilizer made from the treated manure and weed eradication with natural substance, resulting in additional income of approximately 600,000 rupiah. This is local currency per processing cycle. And the second one is biogas production facilities. And the third one is feeding preparation for livestock using crop and resources available in the villages. And the last one is integrated lawn garden mini laboratory for better visualization of land. So the next slide is sustainability and replication. So we think it is very success in the first project. It is important for us to create sustainability program in order to maintain long-term development and can be used by many other communities, not only in the Aboriginal villages. So the outcome of this program is an encouragement for us, Bank Mandiri, and also Gajah Mada University to roll out a similar project and expand its coverage, include the villages in the region, so many people and communities could feel the benefit. Local universities will also continue to be engaged as a project facilitators. Aside from that, economic growth will prepare and proper rural communities to obtain additional financing to further expand their business. This is where Bank Mandiri can serve its primary purposes and convey its ultimate value as an integral part of the society. For replication of this program, we have already has two more target villages to replicate the success of this program to develop independent village program. We call it Argosari and Giwangan. Argosari is a neighboring village, is Desa Argorejo, and the other one, Giwangan, is an urban village, and it's not far away from the previous villages. So the next slide is the program has also received excellent response from the people in the Argorejo villages. So you can see in the slide, here is some of the testimony from people living there. Next slide. Up to screen photos of the program activities from the planning, training, implementation to harvesting stages. We are also grateful for the knowledge and expertise shared by our partners, University of Gajah Mada, and very humble that our program has been welcomed and can be received by the community. Given that corporate social responsibility is uppermost in our mind, we at the Mandiri, Bersama Mandiri program are set to provide more people and more communities with opportunity to be involved in activities that promote wealth creation, economic development, and positive transformation. Let's do it together. We have here what we have to do. We have seen what we need to do. Now is the time to do it, and together we can do it. In closing, I do hope that all of you enjoy the remaining of the evening session. Thank you.